Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss in today's class plane scales. It is one of the type of scale. So plane scale we are taking whenever we have to mark two consecutive units. Here we have to mark meters and decimeters. So these two are the consecutive units, or sometimes decimeters, centimeters. Like that, if two units are given, we need to take the plane scale. Here take the given data initially. Construct a scale of 1:40. To read meters and decimeters and long enough to measure up to 6 meters. Okay, full stop. Mark a distance of 4.7 meters on it. Here we have to construct one scale. Okay, in that scale we have to measure meters. We have to measure meters, decimeters, and then we have to measure up to 6 meters. Okay, by using that scale we can measure up to 6 meters. First write the given data. Here scale of 1:40 means this is RF value. So write RF. RF means it is representative factor. It is equal to given value 1/40. What is RF? It is a ratio of drawing length to the actual length. Okay, it is equal to this given value. Here drawing length means whatever we are doing on the sheet. Okay, we can do within the given space. That is called drawing length. Here actual length means it may be given in meters, okay, decimeters, like that. So in the small space we can't do meters like that. Okay, that is the actual length. This is equal to 1/40. This is a given scale. Here what we have to do, we need to find how much line we have to draw for the scale. Okay, it is called drawing length. What is the actual length given? We have to measure by using that scale up to 6 meters. Okay, it is a maximum limit of that scale. 1 meter means 100 centimeters. Okay, so this scale is 30 centimeter. Okay, so each meter means 100 centimeters. Okay, 6 meters means 600 centimeters. Okay, here in the small space we can't do 600 centimeters or 6 meters. Okay, that's why we have to find out how much length we have to draw. It is called drawing length. So actual length limit is we can measure up to 6 meters. Okay, by using that scale. So we need to find out the drawing length. Keep this values as it is. Drawing length is equal to 1/40 into actual length. This will go this side. Okay, so they always remember this formula is important. Okay, first it is coming how much length we have to draw, that's why it is called drawing length. By maximum limit we can measure by using that scale is 6 meters. Okay, that is actual length. Now substitute that value. Actual length is maximum limit 6 meters. Okay, always remember in drawing length we do in centimeters. Okay, by using scale, small scale we are doing here. Okay, so convert this into in centimeters. As I told, 1 meter means 100 centimeters. Okay, so here 6 into 100 600 centimeters. So whatever value is coming, it is in terms of centimeters. Okay, so do it here. So it is coming 15 centimeters. So drawing length is equal to 15 centimeter. So the main aim is 6 meters means it is 15 centimeters in the drawing sheet. Okay, remember it. We have to calculate this length for doing this line. Okay, 15 centimeters means with this scale we can mark 15 centimeter. Okay, easily. It is called drawing length here. So let us do 15 centimeter line here. From mark the end points. Here it is 0, here it is 15. Join these two ends, we will get 15 centimeter line. Give the end names A here, B here. Here after giving AB, here we have to mark on this scale, okay, all the lengths. So for giving some width to the scale, okay, here take 1 centimeter line. Okay, we are calling this width is arbitrary width. So from A take 1 centimeter point. So 1 centimeter this side and here 1 centimeter from this side. Okay, that width is called arbitrary width. Just we are giving some thickness to the scale. Okay, now join these two ends. Now here we have given AB and give these corners C and D. Okay, this is our scale now. Okay, with this scale, what he has given? This is 15 centimeter drawing length. It is nothing but 15 centimeter means it is. It will measure up to 6 meters. Okay, this scale is 6 meters. Okay, according to our calculation part. Okay. Here, let us take. We have to measure in this scale meters and decimeters also. Now A, B, C, D is the scale we got. This scale can measure up to 6 meters. Okay, so this scale is similar to this scale. Okay, it can measure centimeters and millimeters like that. So this can measure meters, and then here he has given it can read meters and decimeters. Okay, 6 meter scale can measure meters also, up to 6 meters. Okay, so here I will divide this scale, 6 meter scale, into 6 parts. Each part is 1 meter. Okay, so let us do here. Divide this length or scale into 6 equal divisions. Okay, here we have one procedure for how to divide a given length into some required number of equal parts. Okay, now here we need to take one angle line. Okay, that angle is less than 90 degrees, always remember. Okay, here we have, I am doing one angle line which is less than 90 degrees. Okay, we can take any angle here, we can take any angle, no need to measure also, take within 90 degrees. Okay, here just take one point like this and do the join with A. Do one line, join with A. Okay, here I am taking one point, or we can take here also, we can take here also. Okay, it should not come at the 90 degrees. Below 90 we can take any point. Okay, we can join that point to A. Join this point to A. So after getting the line here, take any length, any radius, okay, by using compass, divide into required number of parts. Here we have to divide into 6 parts. Okay, A as center, do one arc on this inclined line, take intersection point as again center, take the same radius, divide into another part, take that intersection point as center, again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, here extend the line. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 divisions with it. Here join this last point to the B with the help of scale. Like this. After joining last point to B, we will get inclined line. At all the points, do the lines parallel to this last line. So with drafter it is easy to do the parallel lines. Fix one of the scale, drafter scale parallel to this, fix that scale and you can move it. Okay, so with this scale it is not possible. What I am taking, I am using roller scale for doing the parallel lines. So keep the scale here inside with the line and move the scale up to this point like this. You will get the parallel lines at all the points. Do the lines up to this scale. Now here give the intersection points. I will start from 0. Okay, I will give mark outside the scale. Okay, 0, 1, 2, this point is 3, this point is 4, this point is 5. Okay, we have divided this into 6 divisions. First division, second division, third division, fourth division, fifth division, sixth division. After that, at all the points, do the vertical lines so that each division is 1 meter. Just take this as a reference. At 4, do the vertical line. Do this vertical. Okay, here we have divided into 6 divisions. Each division is 1 meter. So 1 meter means 10 decimeters. Okay, so we need to do decimeters. What I am taking for decimeters means, here 1 meter means 10 decimeters. First meter I am taking, I am dividing into 10 parts. So each part is 1 decimeters. So how many divisions we have to do? 10 divisions. We have to divide this box into 10 parts. Okay, we have to divide this length into 10 parts. For dividing this length into 10 parts means, again we have to do one angle line. We have to divide that line into 10 parts by using the compass. Take some angle line. As you know the procedure, we have to take the angle any angle we have to take which is less than 90 degrees. Okay, I'm taking at 30. Okay, instead of the same angle, I'm taking at 30. Just join A to this point like this. Okay, divide this line into 10 divisions. Take any radius, take smaller radius because we have to divide this part. Okay, take small radius, any radius here. So to this second line, divide into 10 parts. This is the first part, second part, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Okay, here we did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 parts we did. After getting 10 equal divisions, join the last point to this zero point. Okay, do with scale. Now here at all the points, do the line parallel to this last line. Okay, use the drafter scale, it is easy to do. I am using roller scale. Keep this scale inside with this line. Okay, move the scale at all the points, do the parallel lines. So here I have divided this A and 0 length into 10 equal parts. Give the numbering for this. This is 0, already we have marked. So next division is 1. This is 2. Mark carefully. This is 3. This is 4. This is 5. This is 6. This is 7. This is 8. And this is 9. And A1 is 10. Okay, 10 divisions we did here. Here after giving the numbering, at all the points do the vertical lines. For doing the vertical lines, take one of the line is the reference line. And at one, do the vertical line. Okay, this each is 1 decimeter. Okay, here this is 1 meter, this is 2nd meter, like that. Okay, each box is 1 meter. And here each division is 1 decimeter. Okay. The entire box is also 1 meter. You can measure meters and decimeters also by using this scale. Okay. Now here what he has given after that, this scale should read meters and decimeters. Okay. And then here he has given mark a distance of 4.7 meters on it. Okay. 4 meters, 0.7 meters. 4.7 meters means it is 4 meters plus 0.7 meters. Correct. Okay, 4 plus 0.7 means 4.7 meters. 1 meter means 10 decimeters. Okay, 0.7 meters means 0.7 into 10, right? 4 meters. So 0.7 into 1 meter means 10 decimeters into 10. So it is 4 meters. We can mark directly on the scale. Here 0.7 into 10 means we are getting 7 decimeters. So here we can mark 4 meters. So take starting point here. 4 meters means this is 1 meter, 2 meters, 3 meters, 4 meters. This side we can mark meters. Just do at 4 meters one line, vertical line. Okay, this is the 4 meters from this point to this point. Now after that, 7 decimeters. So 7 decimeters means this side we will mark. Wherever 7 is coming, okay, here 7 is coming on vertical line. So 7 decimeters means 1st decimeter, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 7 decimeters. Just extend this line, 7th line, up to some distance like this for getting the dimensional line. Okay, these are the extension lines. Okay, so this gap is 4.7 meters. Okay, 4.7 meters it is. Now this side 4, this side 0.7 meters means 7 decimeters. So here do the dimensional line, take this is the reference line. So on it extended lines in between. Do the dimensional line. Keep arrows at both sides. Mark here the given value 4.7 meters. At the middle of the line, we can mark 4.7 meters. Now mark the dimension at the middle of the dimensional line, 4.7 meters. After the diagram, after marking the units, write meters this side. Just do two parallel lines in it, write down in capital letters meters, and this side, these are decimeter, and write down the RF value. For every scale, one RF value will be there. For our second scale, RF is 1 by 40.